Hi guys, this is Ranjit, and in this video I'm going to talk about laptops. I generally get a lot of inquiries from you guys specifying, is this specific laptop right for me or not, like this or that, and it can be very difficult for me to guide you all. So I decided to make an overview video, guys, and in fact, as you can see, I've made about 12 pages of notes. So this will give you an overview about how to select a new laptop. So I made a lot of notes. So I'll be looking at this one, and I'll give you an overview what you guys actually need to know before selecting a laptop, because laptop comes in various configuration and you should get the right laptop for your needs, I feel. And to make it simple, guys, what I'll do is I'll divide this into three segments of user. The first segment of users, I would say, is parents, casual users, or students. Next, I would say is then we look at content creators or professionals that really need a laptop. And lastly would be for advanced users or gamers. So we'll divide into that one. But before that, let us actually divide in some of the various categories that you should know before selecting a new laptop. For example, which processor, how to choose the best processor for you. Next, we'll talk about memory, how much memory is good for you. Third is storage and what type of storage do you need. Video card, dedicated video card, integrated, what is good for you. And lastly, we'll also talk about screen resolution and form factor. So these are the various parameters we'll look at. So by end of this video, you should have a broad overview, at least in the direction which laptop might be better for you. And by the way, guys, this video is being made in association with Dell. So I'll also be listing various, laptops, etc. for examples that are found on the Dell lineup. In fact, I'm actually using this Dell XPS 13, as you can see. This is a thin and light. I will talk about that, this one also, later on. By the way, regarding Dell, guys, they have broadly divided their laptops in three lineups. One is the Inspiron lineup, and I feel this is great for just casual users, emailing, posting on social media, movies, etc. Inspiron lineup is good for that. Then we have this XPS lineup. This is for basically a slightly high-end laptop targeted towards content creators. In fact, the build quality is amazing on these laptops. These are also performance oriented, come with the high-end processor. And lastly, we also have the Alienware and the G series of laptops in Dell lineup. These are actually targeted towards gamers, high-end professionals, so they come with cutting-edge processors, graphic cards, and stuff like that. Okay, but let's first dive down regarding the processors, because I feel that's the most important part. And let's talk about Intel processors, as we see a lot of laptops these days with Intel processors. And to give you a broad idea, guys, Intel processors, you can divide them into actually four. That is the Core i3 series, Core i5 series. Then we have the i7 and the i9 series. And then we also have the H series, technically, which again also have the i5, i7. But let's start with the basics. And let's start with the Core i3. Who is this Core i3 processor good for? I would say if you're sort of a casual user, parent, or a student, you do simple tasks, daily tasks like computers, like writing Word documents, Excel sheets, browsing a little bit, consuming a little bit of YouTube stuff like that, then you can have a look at the Inspiron lineup. Here are some of the laptops from Dell with the Inspiron lineup that come with the Core i3 processor, as you can see. Next, I would say this is the Core i5 range of processors, and this is slightly more powerful. In fact, these processors can be used if you are sort of even multitask a lot, I would say. So slightly advanced kind of a user, I think so you should go with the Core i5 processor. These processors also are actually pretty good for intermediate users, and occasionally also if you're doing heavy tasks like photo and video editing occasional, then you can look at the Core i5 range. In fact, in Dell's lineup, as you can see from this screenshot, you can get the entry-level XPS and even G series with the Core i5 processor. And of course, you have a various Inspiron lineup also available on the Core i5. Now, if we talk about the Core i7 and the Core i9 processors, these are the sort of the most powerful processors that you can get from Intel. And these have multi-core. In fact, multi-threading also can come in 6 or 8 cores also. And these are actually ideal for heavy users. For example, personally, this is the XPS 13, that is with the Core i7. And it's a pretty powerful processor. I can even do video editing with this one. So if you're that kind of a person, a content creator, or a person who requires a lot of processing power, then certainly you can look at the Core i7 or even the Core i9 variants of this one. And again, Dell has various laptops with the Core i7 variants. For example, this is the XPS model. Then also in the Alienware and in the G series also, you have quite a few laptops with the Core i7 based processor. Now let's also talk about the H series of the processor. These are again high performance processors, I would say, and they have very high TDP. So if you are a person who needs a lot of processing power continuously, rendering huge projects or something like this, and you need that very high core count, 8 cores and stuff like that, then you can look at the H series of processors. These are specialty processors, I would say. These are also ideal for actually multi-threading, because you can even have 16 threads with these H series processors. Now let's also look at one more series of processor. Intel had actually recently announced this one, and this is the Intel is now giving certification called Intel Evo certified products. Not all laptops have it, but again, whatever products have this Intel Evo certification, if you see that sticker, be assured that actually the laptop will be very thin and light. In fact, it will have very, very good battery life. In fact, this Dell XPS 13 is Intel Evo certified. And if you can see how light this laptop is, and the battery life that I get on this one is fabulous. So again, if you're looking for that thin and light and the best battery life, you have the budget, look for the Intel Evo branding. Not all laptops have it, but quite a few have that. For example, this Dell XPS 13 has the Intel Evo certification. By the way, the current generation of laptops available in the market are coming with the Intel 11th generation, but the upcoming 12th generation processors from Intel will also be coming in the future laptops, so be aware of that. By the way, there are also AMD Ryzen based laptops also available in the market, but I won't talk that about that in this video, because this video will become very, very long. Now let's move, so that was about the processor. Now let's move about, let's talk about memory, which is also a very, very important part. How much memory do you need? A memory also known as random access memory. Think of this one as a storage, temporary storage in your computer's brain, which is required. All your apps, etc., are loaded on that, and when you work on it, memory is required. Don't confuse it with storage. We'll talk about storage later on. So having decent amount of memory is very, very important. If you have very less memory, then maybe your processor might be very, very fast, but it'll get bogged down because of lack of memory. So having enough memory is very, very important. Let's start with the basic. This is the ultra basic amount of RAM that you should have in any new laptop. The very basic, this is the base, I would say, is 4 gigabytes of RAM, and you'll find it on very entry level laptop. But frankly, I would say if you're using a Windows based computer, the minimum RAM that you should look now is about 8 gigabytes of RAM. And I would say that 8 gigabytes of RAM is the sweet spot for many consumers. I would say this gives you a very good balance, and having 8 gigabytes of RAM, you can also do multitasking also, and a little bit of, what do you say, photo editing and creative work also you can do with 8 gigabytes of RAM. Now let's talk about who would require 16 gigabytes of RAM. For example, this Dell XPS 13 that I have, it's configured with 16 gigabytes of RAM. 16 gigabytes of RAM is ideal for content creators or people who require heavy apps. For example, if you're doing video editing or very heavy photo editing and stuff like that, then you might require 16 gigabytes of RAM. Personally, I do a little bit of, what do you say, video editing and stuff. So I feel 16 gigabytes of RAM is the sweet spot, but you can also get computers with 32 gigabytes of RAM. So again, RAM is also very important when you are having a look. By the way, guys, I'm assuming that these RAM requirements are for computers and laptops using Windows-based operating system. Most of them come with Windows 10, and the new ones are actually coming with Windows 11 operating system. Okay, let's move to the next topic, and that is regarding storage. What are the different types of storage, and which is best for you? Okay, let me just get this right. Don't confuse between memory and storage. Memory is a temporary space where actually computer works on what you have given. But again, if you switch off the computer, this data is lost. You need to save this. And this is where storage is required. And storage comes in two variants broadly, guys. That's the normal hard drive and SSD. And again, both are storage, but they're very, very different. I would say the best case scenario is SSD. It's a solid state drive and it's very, very fast. In fact, the boot times on SSD computers for like this is just 6-7 seconds. It just boots out like that. So really, really fast. But the con is that SSDs are actually relatively expensive. The second type of storage that we have is the normal hard drive. The advantage of a normal hard drive is that it's relatively affordable. Hence, you get it in very high capacities like 1 terabyte, 2 terabytes, even 4 terabytes of storage. And I would say, so decide what you want. And if you are taking a performance based laptop or something like that, if a creative professional, then I would lean you towards the computer based with SSD. For example, this XPS 13 that I have is having a very fast SSD. There is also another thing that I'm seeing in some of the laptops. In fact, Dell also actually has quite a few laptops. This is using a hybrid solution. That means they have an SSD for the boot drive and application, generally a 256 gigabyte SSD or something like that. That's more than enough for your Windows and your apps. Then they also have a separate hard drive, which can be actually used to actually store big apps or big storage needs. So a hybrid of both. And this is also a nice solution. In fact, Dell also has quite a few actually laptops with this hybrid kind of a solution, as you can see with this screenshot. Now let's talk about graphic cards. Do you need, and graphic cards come in two variants, guys. A dedicated graphic card, that's a separate, component on your laptop, and an integrated one that is with your computer's processor's chip itself. Let's first talk about integrated, graphic card. And these are okay for casual users or mid-level users. And Intel actually has the UHD graphics card, and also the newer ones. Intel has recently produced in some of the performance laptops. That's the Intel Iris Xe. And as you can see from this screenshot from this reputable website, it's actually supposed to be almost 4 times more powerful than Intel UHD. So again, this is regarding integrated graphic cards. If you are getting a laptop with the Intel Iris Xe, though it's an integrated one, it's actually pretty good. And many of the performance laptops actually come with that. In fact, many of the Dell Inspiron come with the integrated graphic card. That's also known as the GPU. Now let's talk about dedicated GPU. This dedicated GPU is a card on itself. It has its own memory, it has its own processor. So obviously it's a lot more powerful compared to an integrated solution. And this is ideal for if you are sort of a content creator or a gamer, then you need a dedicated GPU. In fact, for content creators, I say it's also important because many of the video editing softwares take advantage of an external GPU. That way, when you are rendering or exporting, it speeds up the process. And of course, for gamers, if you are sort of a serious gamer, then you need dedicated GPU. Again, you can get GPUs from AMD, NVIDIA, GDX, etc. And again, Dell, as you can see, has a lot of laptops with dedicated graphic cards. Now let's talk about the last thing, that is the screen size and the resolution and the form factor. First, let's talk about the screen size of laptops. If you know, laptops comes in various screen sizes, ranging from 13 inches, 14 inches, 15, 17, etc. First, let's talk about the portable laptops. I would say portable laptops generally you'll find in the 13 and the 14. In fact, this is the Dell XPS 13. That means it's the 13 inch laptop. And just notice how light it is. I can just hold this laptop. It's just 1.1 kilograms. So if you're looking for that lightness, obviously go with a 13 or a 14 inch laptop. I would say then you have the 15 inch laptops also. And this is a very good medium between portability and productivity. If you are a person who was a content creator or something like that, then I would say go with at least a 15 inch screen because you get a little bit more real estate to work with. And again, Dell has a lot of laptops, again in 13, 14, 15 inches also. And also then we have the slightly higher range, that's the 17 inches. I would urge, again, serious content professional, for example, if you're doing heavy video editing or photo editing on your laptop itself, then I would lean towards a 17 inch screen, though it's slightly heavy. And also gamers, if you're sort of a heavy gamer, then you can look at 17 inch laptops. So this is regarding just the screen, but what about the screen resolution? I would say basic screen resolution that you should look today is a full HD screen. That's a 1080p screen that you are getting. And then we also have higher resolution screens. If you're sort of a content creator or a video editor or something, maybe you'll require a higher resolution screen like a 2K or a 4K screen also. So look at that. If you're sort of a content creator, then you might look at a quad HD or even a 4K screen. This is also applicable to graphic artists or something, or photographers where they want to zoom in and look at a lot of detail. Okay, finally, then there is the form factor. Laptops, you get in a lot of form factors. For example, this is a regular form factor laptop, a regular one that you see, clamshell type. But we also have 2-in-1s also available in the market. And for example, they convert to like a tablet also. You can hold it in your hand. So if that is your requirement, you can also look at a 2-in-1 based laptop. In fact, Dell Inspiron range has actually quite a bit of 2-in-1s laptops also. So guys, I hope you have a better understanding about basics of laptops and how to go about a particular laptop based on your requirements. What I'll do is I'll also leave the links of some of the Dell laptops in various ranges so that you can check it out. Anyways, guys, that's it for now for this video. I hope you like this video. If you like these kinds of video, I'll also try to make videos on other topics like this. And anyways, guys, thanks Dell for sponsoring this video. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video. Take care, guys.